Hi all, today we are going to discuss about insulation resistance and capacitance of single core cable. So let us start with the insulation resistance. If you are taking any cable, that cable will have a conductor, and above this conductor there will be a sheath, and between these two it is covered by some insulating material. So it will be covered like this. So it will have like this. So let us take the length of this cable. I am taking as L. L is the length of the cable, and the inner radius of this conductor, or the radius of the conductor, I am representing by R1, and the radius up to the sheath I am representing by R2. So between the outer sheath, because this outer sheath is connected to ground, and between this outer sheath and this inner conductor, this is filled by the insulating material. So actually, if you take the cable, actually current is supposed to pass through the cable like this. Current is supposed to pass through the conductor. But practically, because it is like a some conductor is at there at some potential, and there is the sheath that is at the ground potential. So due to the potential difference, the leakage current will pass between this conductor and the sheath. So this we can try to view from the side view. So this I can represent like this. This is my outer sheath, and this is my conductor. So from the conductor to the outer sheet, the current will start leaking like this. The current will leak from surface of the conductor to the outer sheet or to the ground. So this is called as the leakage current. So you can see here, leakage current is not in the direction of the current. It is in the tangential direction, or the radial direction from the center of the conductor. This is along the radial direction from the center of the conductor. As this current is going west, it is not intended to pass in this direction, so that's why we call it as a leakage current. Let us take for example, rho is the specific resistance of insulating material. So before proceeding, I want to tell you one thing. I am writing on a glass screen, so the handwriting doesn't come properly. So I am providing the complete handwritten material in the description of this video. You can download the handwritten material from there. Here you try to understand the concept, because the entire concept cannot be written in the material. So here you try to understand the concept. Remaining theory or other related things, you can please download from the description of this video. So now let L is the length of the cable. And let us take the inner radius of the cable. I am taking as R1. R1 is the radius of conductor, and R2 is the radius of internal sheath, the radius up to the internal sheath of the cable, or the thickness of the cable. So whatever way you call it. So let to analyze this leakage resistance. So what I am doing, if you are taking this as my cable, so inside there is a conductor. It is having a resistance of R1, sorry, radius of R1. This is having a radius of R2. So I am taking at a distance of X from the center of the conductor. Let us assume I am taking at a distance X. So here I am taking a small thickness, so that the thickness should be that much less. There will be small change in the value of the parameters, whatever you are calculating. So this I am taking as dx. So I am taking a small dx. So the cross-sectional area through which the leakage current passes, because leakage current is passing through in the radial direction, leakage current is passing like this. So cross-sectional area at a distance of x through which the leakage current passes, that cross-sectional area will be equal to 2 pi x is the circumference multiplied by L is the length of the cable. So this is the cross-sectional area through which it passes. So insulation resistance, so in this small thickness of the layer dx, insulation resistance, this will be equal to, because rho L by A is the formula for the resistance, rho multiplied by how much distance it is traveling. It is traveling by distance of dx divided by area. Area is 2 pi x into L. This is what happens in this small area. Or if you want the total insulation resistance, I can calculate by R is equal to, do the integration from the surface of the conductor to the surface of the sheath. So R1 to R2, rho dx divided by 2 pi x into L. So let us take out the common things or the constant things. Rho divided by 2 pi L is constant. This becomes integration from R1 to R2. This will be dx divided by x. What is dx by x? Integration of dx by x will be ln of x. So you can substitute the limits. So your insulation resistance will become equal to rho by 2 pi L into ln of R2 by R1. So this is the formula for insulation resistance of the cable. So here, while calculating the insulation resistance of the cable, you can observe that the value of the insulation resistance is inversely proportional to the length, because normally in the case of normal resistance or series resistance, we know that it is proportional to the length, but here this insulation resistance is inversely proportional to length of the cable. So what is the meaning of this? As the length of the cable is increased, so automatically the insulation resistance will decrease. When the insulation resistance decreases, so the leakage current increases. So as the leakage current is increasing, means the losses are increasing. So this thing you have to remember. So here it is a quite different type of analysis. So let us take one example to understand this. So after that, we will go for capacitance of single core cable. So it is given the insulation resistance of a single core cable is 495 mega ohm per kilometer if the core diameter is 2.5 centimeters and resistivity of insulation is 4.5 into 10 to the power of 14 ohm centimeter, find the insulation thickness. This is what is asked. So let us try to calculate this one. So let us first note down what is the given data. The data is given that this much ohm is given in 1 kilometer, or length is nothing but 1 kilometer, that is equal to 1000 meters. And the insulation resistance is given as 495 mega ohm, that is 495 into 10 to the power of 6 ohms. And then the radius of the conductor, or inner radius of the conductor R1, is equal to diameter divided by 2. So this will be 1.25 centimeters. And the specific resistance or the resistivity is given as 4.5 into 10 to the power of 14 ohm centimeter. I have to convert to meter. So this will become equal to 4.5 into 10 to the power of 12 ohm meter. This we have got. So we have seen the insulation resistance R is equal to rho by 2 pi L into ln of R2 by R1. This is what we have seen. Let us try to substitute whatever variables are available. This will be equal to 495 into 10 to the power of 6 is equal to rho is 4.5 into 10 to the power of 12 divided by 2 pi into length of the cable is equal to 1000 meters. So 1000 I can write ln of R2 I don't know, and the value of R1 is 1.25. So if you solve for the value of R2, you will get the value of this R2 as 2.5 centimeters. That means the outer radius is equal to 2.5 centimeters. So it is asked what is the thickness of insulation. So from this I can calculate my thickness of insulation is equal to capital R minus small r. This will be equal to 2.5 minus 1.25. So in our example, it is taken as R2 and R1, right? So R2 minus R1 is equal to 2.5 minus 1.25. This will be equal to 1.25 centimeters. So this way you have to calculate. Let us now see what is the capacitance of single core cable. So capacitance of single core cable. So again, to calculate the capacitance of the single core cable, I am taking the core and I am taking the sheath. So that is, assume this is given by small d by 2 is the diameter. I am representing internal diameter as small d, and external diameter I am representing by capital D. So the radius becomes equal to capital D by T, and this sheath is connected to ground, and this conductor is carrying the current. Let us assume I am taking a distance x from the center of the conductor to analyze this. So this is at a distance of x. So first thing, I am assuming that the charge that is carried by the conductor is q coulombs per meter length of the charge is passed by the conductor, and epsilon is permittivity of the insulating medium, which will be equal to epsilon naught multiplied by epsilon r. And the next one, we are taking that the sheath is at a ground potential. So let us calculate the electric field intensity at a distance x from the center of the conductor, can be calculated by Ex is equal to this q divided by 2 pi epsilon x. This we have already derived in electromagnetics. If you have doubt, you can please refer to my electromagnetics lectures on, and you can see the lecture on electric field intensity. So there I have derived all these things. So now if you want to calculate the potential, total potential difference between the conductor and the sheath, because we know V is the potential difference between them, that V will be equal to negative gradient of E, so integration of Ex dx. So what you have to do the integration? You have to do the integration against the direction of the electric field. Always the electric field comes from the positive terminal to the negative terminal, or the direction of electric field will be like this. This is my direction of the electric field. You have to move from against the direction, so that's why we represent by minus, and we are moving from the outer radius, that is d by 2, to surface of the conductor d by 2. Why we are not taking up to the center of the conductor? The reason is the conductor is a equipotential surface. Inside the conductor the electric field will be equal to zero. So this also I have discussed in electromagnetics. If you want the details, you can please refer from there. So this will be equal to d by 2 to small d by 2. This will be equal to q divided by 2 pi epsilon x dx, or this I can write as q divided by 2 pi epsilon into ln of capital D by small d if you substitute it. Oh, now I can calculate my value of the capacitance. Capacitance is nothing but charge per voltage, so q divided by v. So q divided by will be q divided by this equation will come. So I am directly writing the answer. This will become equal to 2 pi epsilon divided by ln of capital D by small d farads per meter length. So you can see here the capacitance is farads per meter length. So if you are taking the cable, so if you are taking this cable, so this is my outer radius of the cable. You have to remember that capacitance is formed everywhere. One capacitance is formed here. Similarly, capacitance is formed here. Capacitance is formed here. We are calculating the capacitance per unit length. This is just equivalent to multiple capacitors are connected in parallel. So in the parallel combination, the capacitances will add to each other. Or if you want to calculate the total capacitance and you know the length of your cable, let us take it as L. So total capacitance will be the capacitance per meter distance multiplied by length of the cable in meters. So in that way you can calculate the total capacitance. To understand the concept of the capacitance completely, let us take one example so that it will be completely clear to you. A 33 kV 50 hertz 3 phase underground cable 4 kilometers long uses 3 single core cables. Each of the conductor has a diameter of 2.5 centimeters and the radial thickness of insulation is 0.5 centimeters. So it is asked to determine, the first part asked is capacitance of cable per phase, and the second part asked charging current per phase, and the third one asked is total charging kVAr, and it is also given the relative permittivity of insulation is 3. Relative permittivity is also given. So let us try to calculate what is asked. So we know the capacitance C is equal to 2 pi epsilon, that epsilon can be written as epsilon naught into epsilon r divided by ln of capital D by small d farads per meter. We have to substitute these things. So this will be equal to 2 pi into epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power of minus 12 multiplied by epsilon r is equal to 3 divided by ln of capital D by small d. So small d is already given, the conductor has a diameter of 2.5, and it is given the thickness of the insulation is 0.5 centimeters. That means it is given there the small d is equal to 2.5 and this thickness is equal to 0.5. So if you want to add, this side also 0.5 will add. So we can tell that total diameter of the outer radius, or the complete diameter, outer diameter will be 2.5 plus 2 times of 0.5. This will become equal to 3.5. So I have written 3.5 here. So if you are substituting the 3.5, this will be in farads per meter. Please remember this. So this you will get as 496.011 into 10 to the power of minus 12 farads per meter. So now the total capacitance is asked, right? The total capacitance per phase will be equal to this capacitance per meter multiplied by length in meters. So this will be equal to 496.011 into 10 to the power of minus 12 multiplied by 4 into 10 to the power of 3. So if you do the multiplication of this, this becomes 1984 into 10 to the power of minus 9 farads. That is the total capacitance. Now the second part, the charging current per phase. So the charging current will be equal to voltage divided by the impedance. So this I can write as V phase divided by XC is 1 by 2 pi FC. This is what we get. So this I can write as V phase can be written as VL divided by root 3. This 2 pi FC will go to the numerator. This will become 2 pi into F into C. So this value we will write. So we know our line value of the voltage because it is 3 phase. That is why I have taken as VL. Line value of voltage is 33 into 10 to the power of 3 divided by root 3. This will be 2 pi into frequency of supply is 50 multiplied by the value of the capacitance of the cable. This is 1984 into 10 to the power of minus 9. 10 to the power of minus 9. So this if you calculate, this you will get as 11.87 amperes. This much value of the charging current is passing. So now it is asked total charging VAR. So charging KVAR. Total charging KVAR will be equal to, because there are 3 phases, so 3 multiplied by voltage per phase into charging current per phase. So because 3 cables are there, that is why I am multiplying with 3. If it is single core cable, you have to only take 1. Please remember this. So this will become 3 times of 33 into 10 to the power of 3 divided by root 3 into 11.87. So if you calculate this, you will get it as 678.5. 10 to the power of 3 I am converting to VAR. So this will become KVAR. This way you have to calculate the things. I hope how to calculate the insulation resistance and capacitance of single core cable and how to solve the numericals is clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.